okay? And don't tell me that it's nothing, because you've been acting strange from the second I picked you up from that clinic, and now I have to beg you to spend some free time with me. So what is happening?
We shouldn't talk about this here, Pacey.
So I'm right.
Look, this is not the time, okay?
Is it me? Okay, are you trying to end things? Is that what this is about?
No, God, that's the last thing that I want.
Fine, then what is so awful you've waited so long to tell me about it, Andy?
A lot happened to me this summer, Pacey. A lot.
What are you trying to say?
Okay, if we're gonna talk about this now, then you have to promise me that you will not say one word until I'm done. No, promise me, Pacey.
Okay, I promise. Just tell me what's wrong.
When I went to Mayfield to get better, I wasn't myself anymore. I wasn't the same person who came to Capeside. I wasn't the girl you fell in love with. My first week I met Mark, and he had been through everything I had been through and more. In and out of facilities 3 times, on and off medication since he was 9. I didn't write to you about him because I didn't want you to get jealous. We were just friends. You know, we'd spend our free time together just talking endlessly. Mostly about our fears. I was so afraid, PC. Afraid of everything. I was scared that they were never gonna let me out of there, or that whatever was broken inside me wouldn't be fixable. And Mark, he understood these things like nobody else could, because they were his fears too. He had a girlfriend that he was anxious to get back to.
You slept with him?
We knew immediately afterwards that it was wrong for both of us.
You slept with him, Andy.
We decided just to continue to be friends and not tell our significant others, but then when I saw you, Casey, it was the biggest mistake of my life. And all I keep thinking about right now is, what if you can't forgive me? I mean, Casey, you have to forgive me, please. You have to forgive me.
Thank you. joking? Let's go back to the incident. I come home from work after I left early, which I never do, by the way, but I got in a fight with Nancy, the school high school principal. I come home, and what's playing but the song from my wedding? The song that you so charmingly played out here today for us. That's playing, and I don't think anything of it, which is odd, because I should have. I come home, what do I see? I walk in the door, and I see underwear and pieces of clothing and a guy's pants with his belt in it. And I walk up the stairs, and all of a sudden I see the DVD player. And on the DVD player is the CD, and it's playing the wedding song. And then I look down, and I see my wife's panties on the ground. And then I look up. I look up, and I see her naked in the shower. And I think, oh, that's kind of sweet. She's in the shower. What a perfect thing. I'm going to find her. Maybe I'll go in there. We never fuck in the shower anymore. Maybe today we will. I pull the curtain back, and there's the fucking history teacher with tenure. And you know what he says to me? You should probably go. That's what he says to me.
We'll be right back. Thank you. please, what you gave will last me all my life. Yeah, hey.